We are at a place called Babel Platz in Berlin. It's this big popular square, and it's really well known because right at this place there were about 20,000 books that were burned, and there is this memorial that has been created over here. You can actually see shelves over here which can hold exactly about 20,000 books. So it's sort of, you know, made in memory of those books that were burned by the Nazis to basically remove all of the Jewish history. Okay, so we are at one of the most popular squares of Berlin, and this place completely comes alive during, a couple of weeks before Christmas with the whole Christmas market. So things are going to completely change around here. But for now, some very interesting things to note. So for example, it starts over here. This was a French church that was built for the French that used to be here during the whole wartime, because of course they could not attend sermon that was in German. They needed a French chapel to go and listen to the sermon, so this was built for them. And when they built this, the Germans decided that they also needed a church right next to that. So then they built this, which is modeled exactly like the French church, but just because it was in Germany and they wanted to, you know, prove that they have a slightly better church, they made this just about 14 centimeters taller. So that's the interesting history between both of these. Okay, so what's behind me is the Checkpoint Charlie. It's one of the most touristic spots of this whole place. And the history behind it is this was part of the American-controlled portion of Berlin. And since it was also gate number 3, Americans called it Checkpoint Charlie because Charlie is Alpha Bravo Charlie. So that's why it was Checkpoint 3. But right now it's a massively touristy spot. But one interesting thing over here are these colored pipes. So sometime back, these were actually used to clean the sewage that
swamp water
had been built on top. But right now it's more like another interesting thing to just take photos. Front of the Trabant Museum. This is basically the museum for all of these Trabant cars. The interesting thing about these Trabant cars is that this was a car that the people of the communist part of East Germany used to drive. Because communism basically meant, the philosophy of communism is that everyone should have access to the same things, irrespective of, you know, which caste, which class, or how much money you have. So therefore, these were the cars that people used to have. They were all exactly the same. And the funny thing was, even the locks were the same. So essentially, you know, you could always open another Trabant car and probably drive away and nobody would know. And the other interesting thing about this is the car is actually made of fiberglass and not metal. So they never rust and they just last for a really long time. But unfortunately, the engines that were being used were really sad, and that's why they don't move anymore. But wish they could move because they're pretty cute to look at. So we're standing right in front of a portion of the Berlin Wall that is still intact. And it's only one of the three portions of the Berlin Wall that most people come and see. It's right there. But the interesting thing still is, there are parts of the Berlin Wall that you can still find all across the city. And right here is one of them. Berlin Wall, and it's just lying over here. And we just went into the store and asked him, no, is this part of the real Berlin Wall? And then he tells us, yeah, it is, and it's even for sale. You can take it if you want. He just quoted a price of 6,000 euros, but that's how this wall is now. You know, just all over the place for people to just take and do what they want. That's so this is a really interesting piece of history. Where we are standing on right now was actually the bunker where Hitler not only coordinated most of the work that he was doing, but also the place where he finally died. It was actually here. And the reason why it is not a big touristy spot, or, you know, there are no signboards claiming it, is because the Germans really wanted to underplay it. So they just filled up the bunker with concrete and just converted it into a car parking lot. And I think that's really awesome. This place is called the Holocaust Memorial. And what's unique about this place is that it was built by a very famous Jewish architect. And he built this with certain, you know, idiosyncrasies. So for example, each of these concretes that you see are exactly the same width and breadth. So everywhere you stand, you can see absolute straight lines. But they're all of different heights. And basically nobody has any clue why he's designed it that way. Another thing that you can notice, they're smooth on the sides but rough on the top. And also there are exactly 2,211 of them over here. So a bunch of weird statistics. And he just built this just to, you know, showcase the kind of atrocities that happened to the whole Jewish community by the Nazis, and at the same time left all of this unexplained. It's just for us to interpret what this means, and it's, you know, we can interpret it whichever way we want.